What's common to all of us in movement, even if somebody has a severe disability and can't move very well, there's something that, you know, we're genetically very similar, where we all have, you know, most of the part, bones, skeleton, muscle. There's a common element, and if I could understand that common element more, I could then provide insight in how to design things that would make life better for everybody. This is the Human Biomechanics Design Lab, and in this lab what we work on is how people move.
The study I've been working on this summer will make it easier to test for on-field concussions, say in football games or soccer games.
We might be able to help somebody who's had an injury walk more effectively or be more efficient in their movement.
Or analyze injuries, you know, how they happen, how they occur, why they occur, and then try to make preventative measures to try to reduce or eliminate those injuries.
So if there was a way that I could still perform to 100% and not get injured, that would be perfect.
It means coming down to the labs, doing research, exploring questions.
There's lots of great opportunities for students to have hands-on experiences.
And basically do it all ourselves as if we were, you know, in a job.
This lab is the students' lab. I mean, I'm here to manage it to some extent and to make sure that people are doing things that, you know, can be done, and ultimately to allow you to learn on how to do research and to apply the tools that we have.
Strongest one here.
Bioengineering is a bridge between the engineering world and the medical world.
You're applying mechanical and like computer science to it, but also you have the medical terminology, and sometimes you understand a little bit more about it than just a mechanical engineer would.
I've always loved math, you know, and engineering ever since I was a kid, and I've always wanted to help people, and it's probably the best way I see that I could incorporate both things into one career.